In this lesson, we're going to be looking in more detail about how it is mathematically that we have rolling without slipping, in this case for a uniform disk, as it says here. So it's our solid disk with our moment of inertia, 1/2 mr squared over here. So it's, again, as it says here, like a rolling pin, and you're going to push it like you would push a rolling pin along the axle and push forward. And this disk will roll without slipping as long as there is enough friction, static friction, between the base of the wheel and the table to allow it to roll without slipping. So what we want to look at is the relationship between this coefficient of friction down here and the frictional force and the force that we're pushing at, to see how hard can we push before you wouldn't have rolling without slipping. So if this coefficient of friction, let's say, is really small, there's a little bit of friction, but not much, the force push is still going to translate the wheel forward. The frictional force, even if it's just a little bit of frictional force, is still going to generate a torque and cause rotation. So we'll still get this same rotation, which we'll see with our cross product mathematically in a moment. But it won't be rolling without slipping. You'll just be pushing the wheel forward. You'll have some rotation, but it won't be that locked in rotation where, when it's rolling without slipping, we have our conditions where V center of mass equals omega r and A center of mass equals alpha r. You just have pushing and rotating, but not that connection. Okay, so let's start where it says to start. We'll start over here with the torque. We have sum of the torques equals I alpha. We need to identify our pivot point before we calculate torque. Since this wheel is rolling about its central axis, that's the natural pivot point to choose. We are going to do R cross F. Our vector is from the pivot point to where the force acts. So for our little example here, let's draw it explicitly from a common origin and talk about the R cross F. We have 90 degrees, so there's our sine of 90 degrees from our cross product, magnitude of first, magnitude of the second, sine of the angle between the two. Magnitude of the first is R, magnitude of the second is force of friction, mu times the force normal, which is mu mg. And when we do our right-hand rule, this is going to be the awkward reverse your hand. So you're going to kind of reverse karate chop, reverse your hand, put it way upside down, twist it back so your fingers are kind of pointing to your jaw, R cross F, make a thumb, make a fist, thumb down into the paper. And there is our clockwise rotation. Moment of inertia is 1/2 mr squared, as it says here. So that's our moment of inertia, 1/2 mr squared. Since we are looking at rolling without slipping, we're going to lock the acceleration and the rotation into that condition. So A center of mass equals alpha r. So alpha equals A on r. So that's where we get this one. And then, of course, you can see we get very nice cancellation here. We lose the m's. If we bring the r here down here, we have r squared, so we lose the r's. So there you have it. We have our relationship between the coefficient of friction and the acceleration of the wheel. We rearrange it to solve for the acceleration of the wheel. And as it says here in my explosive statement, so anytime I have these explosive statements, please make sure you get them into your notes. This relationship between the acceleration and the coefficient of friction gives us not just an acceleration value, but our maximum acceleration. So no matter what that coefficient of friction is, if I have a value for it, I plug it in here, g is 9.8. Whatever number that is, that's the acceleration that will correspond to rolling without slipping. It can be less than that value. It cannot be greater. If it's greater, then as we said when we started our discussion, the force will still push the wheel forward. The wheel will still spin, it'll still rotate, but not with A center of mass equals alpha r. Okay, now we can finish up, I think, nice and quickly here. We go over to our F equals MA, and we get an interesting result that it might be natural, if you didn't think too deeply about it, just to say F equals MA and the only F is the blue F here pushing the pin forward, but that is not the case. So please note that the frictional force, even though it's static friction, is still to the left, and then we have to include it in our sum of the forces. So we have sum of the forces equals mass times acceleration, F minus mu times the force normal, mg equals ma, so our force push blue forward in general is given by ma plus mu mg, as it says here. And when we plug in our maximum acceleration, right, for A, that's our purple A from over here, we get the maximum force, which is 3 mu mg. So please annotate this page very carefully. Let me erase my extra comments here so you can take a look at it. Because there is nothing on this page mathematically that is difficult at all. This type of question has appeared both in multiple choice and free response questions for the AP test. So you would be expected to be able to go through this type of analysis. Again, if you have any questions or think of anything to discuss in class about this, please bring it up with me and we will address this in class as well.